The year was 1985. The place, Hollywood, California. The band?
Steel Panther was absolutely groundbreaking.
Steel Panther kicks ass.
Great on stage, great music. They had it all going on.
These guys are rock and roll. I mean, they set the tempo for what we all do.
Yeah, I mean, whatever happened to those assholes?
What happened to those assholes, indeed? From the sordid streets of Hollywood, four brash and not too bright young men came together to form the greatest metal band you never heard. This is a story of heavy metal dreams, wasted days, and a destiny finally fulfilled 20 years later. This is Steel Panther, Behind the Music. The local band that everyone knew but nobody talked about didn't start out as your usual rock and roll band.
Man, back in high school we used to hang out and just get high. And, you know, I figured, why not hang out, get high, and get laid?
So we went down to the Guitar Center and we just took a vote on who looked the coolest behind each instrument.
And I knew right at that point, we gotta start a fucking band. You know, because the way we look on stage, dude, we get fucking snatched. Every fucking night. And what's more important than getting pussy?
And from those humble beginnings, Steel Panther started a heavy metal journey that baffled and enthralled the entire metal community.
I totally heard about them, and the first time I saw them, I was kind of like, what the fuck am I looking at?
After seeing them on stage and the kind of energy that they had, I called up my buddy Perry Farrell. I was like, dude, you gotta hear these guys. I mean, we were sitting in the audience, we looked at each other, we were like, this is it. And it blew our minds, and from that day forward, we decided to form Jane's Addiction.
Let me tell you, of all the musicians I ever had the pleasure of knowing, Steel Panther was by far the most filthy, degrading gangbang I ever took part in.
Success came quickly for the spandex-clad quartet. Some say, too quickly.
Those other bands, they were bum, man. They would come up to us all the time, whining like little girls. You guys are getting the best gigs. You guys are snorting the best blow. You guys are screwing our chicks on a regular basis.
Dude, they fucked my mom, okay? I don't know how they did that. She never even saw a show.
Whether they were jamming to sold-out shows or jizzing on passed-out groupies, Steel Panther had only one way to go, and that was up.
Well, you know, at that point, we realized that we're rockers, man. We don't have time to worry about adding and subtracting and shit. So I thought it'd be a good idea to get a manager, you know, that can handle all that shit and we can still party.
The band hired their friend Michael Ockertz as their new manager. Ockertz used his natural salesman abilities he honed selling weed to convince all the labels to send their A&R departments to a Steel Panther showcase.
These schmucks didn't know it at the time, but they were about to be signed to the most lucrative contract in rock and roll history.
But it never happened. Steel Panther never showed. The labels did, however, and signed Jane's Addiction.
The fact that they just kind of never showed up and vanished was, to me, probably the most metal move they could have made.
Apparently, the manager said for them to show up at the showcase, to go to the showcase, they thought he said, go get shit-faced. That was the last time anybody heard from them.
No one knows exactly what happened next. Steel Panther vanished.
My money's on drugs. I heard they were seriously into acid, like battery acid, like actual car battery acid. That shit will fuck you up six ways to Sunday.
I was there and I forgot.
But the truth was never to be discovered, and the Steel Panther phenomenon to be quickly faded into obscurity.
When I was an intern at Atlantic Records, I heard about Steel Panther for the first time. Here we are in 2008, I'm now running Universal Republic, and one day I get this mysterious package in the mail. I open it up, there's a disc, so of course I'm intrigued. I put it in, and I'm here to tell you, without question, the best rock album I've ever heard. And then it hits me like a bolt of lightning. 20 years ago to the day, Steel Panther disappears. Dude, that's fucking freaky.
Could the music Monte Lipman heard actually be Steel Panther? Only four men could answer that question.
we're back.
The new album delivered on the promise made 20 years earlier, and Steel Panther's return once again shook the music industry to its core.
It's a fucking heavy metal record, and when you hear it, you're gonna shit your dick off.
This is a great fucking record.
It's the first real rock record in what, 20 years?
Steel Panther, more like Steel Balls. Have you heard it yet? To go where those guys went musically, you gotta have balls of steel.
To me, it was worth the 20-year wait.
That's crazy, man. 20 years to make a record? Who would do that?
And so the Steel Panther story continues with their epic soon-to-be-released CD as its latest chapter. But this story will continue. Lexi Fox, Satchel, Styx Zedinya, and Michael Starr will go on like that never-ending story movie, but not as gay.